Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Two Eyes. How y'all doing? If y'all don't notice, I'm looking rather scrumdiddlyumptious today, nigga.
Whoa,
now. You got too much dip on your chip.
You know why? Because I got a new fucking camera. I got a new camera. If you notice, the shit's kind of wider. You see a bit more of my room than I want you to see. But you know what? It's fine. It's part of the aesthetic. I gotta throw something else on the walls now. Fuck. This shit is about to go fucking bananas. Okay, so pretty much I got spoiled that fucking Kazuya was in the new DLC for Smash Brothers. So it sucked that I got spoiled because I'm like, fuck's gonna happen. You know? Damn, I was gonna be excited. I love Tekken. I fucking love Tekken. My friend knows I love Tekken. He's the one that showed me this fucking video. He's the one that fucking recommended me to react to this video. Shout out to you, my boy. Shout out to you. But hopefully I won't be rambling on for crazy amounts of time, because all I know is that either I'm gonna have to do a long ass video or I'm gonna have to break this down into videos. I don't know, you'll see my decision by however much I upload the shit. Anyway, so we're gonna learn moves for the moves for Kazuya. And my friend thought, you know what, since I actually play fucking Tekken, even though I don't main Kazuya, I still play fucking Tekken, I still love Tekken. Like, I've been playing Tekken since Tekken 3 on the original PlayStation. Like, I've been in this shit for a minute. But that's not besides the point. That's part of the point. The point is that I'm really curious to see what Sakurai did with Kazuya. Because he does every character he puts in this game justice. The fact that Minecraft Steve actually has a moveset, and it's actually compatible with the actual game of Minecraft, that's fucking perplexing. Honestly though, if there is any other DLC that I personally would love to be added, it would be Sora from Kingdom Hearts. I want Sora from fucking Kingdom Hearts in the damn game. But that's beside the point. The point is, we're gonna see how Sakurai did my boy Kazuya justice, representing Tekken. Okay, this wasn't even my idea, it's my friend's idea, shouts out to him. Let's see, because at the same time, even when I reacted, even though I didn't react to it, I watched the I still watched the video afterwards, because I was upset, because I got spoiled as to who was going in, and honestly, the trailer was fucking dope and hilarious too, but when the fucking Devil Kazuya broke out, that shit went crazy. If y'all are ready, like I'm ready, we're going to see what Mr. Sakurai did with Kazuya. I want to see how accurate it is to the game. And yo, if they got a 10 hit, if they actually have a 10 hit fucking combo in this game, I'm gonna go fucking ballistic. But anyway, here we go.
Okay. What? Okay. Dang. Quit this! You gotta ask for this. I'm sorry, dude. Okay, wait. That jump back air was fucking... Wait. Okay, wait. Sternum smash. Flash tornado? Okay, bet. They got the fucking dragon uppercut. Yes. Please tell me he spins twice. Oh, he doesn't. Okay, but still, that's like an up smash, I'm guessing. Oh shit! The spinning demon to left. Yo, wait. If they have the whole, I doubt they're gonna have the whole spinning demon. But if they have the whole spinning demon, that shit would be fucking stupid. And I know people would try to abuse the fuck out of that. Just to do it. Spinning demon at left hook is still, that's still a good variation of it to be able to put in the smash. It's quick enough to be able to hit, but at the same time, it's still relevant enough to the character to where it makes sense. Dragon uppercut, bitch. Yes. Oh, bad. What? He has two grabs? I don't know how Smash works, obviously, because I'm surprised the fact he has two grabs. Yes! Wait, that's a stun? Wait a fucking minute, hold up. I mean, it makes sense, but shit. Big grab, yes. Yes! here for all of it. I'm here for all of it. Yes. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Wave dash you. Wave that. They got the fucking wave dash in this bitch. I am here. Yo, Sakurai. Sakurai. Mr. Sakurai, if you will. Thank you. Thank you. You got the... Look, okay. For anybody who plays Tekken, right? One thing you know about Kazuya, especially like a high-level play, one thing that's very synonymous with Kazuya is his wave dash, wave dash, wave dash, to where you go down and forward really quickly, to where you can be back here. He's right here. Fucking close the gap real quick. Beat this nigga's ass. Okay? But the fact they got fucking wave dash in here, or crouch dash, I love to fucking see it. The fact they got the full... Bro, I was kidding. I didn't expect them to actually have this in the game. This fucking roundhouse triple kicks. I did not expect them to have this shit in the game. This shit is dope already. Let's go. It's still more. Yeah, let's ooh! Got that ratchet! Demon fist! Wait. Can you do... Oh, no, I doubt you can. I'm curious, though, if you can do demon fist into triples... Into the fucking, spinning devil kick. I'm curious. Into the spinning kick, whatever the fuck it's called. I'm curious whether or not you could do that. Just kick by Stonehead and break it. Man. Woo! Got that grab too? Oh, wait, what the fuck? Nice. Yes! Okay, one of Kazuya's, like, signature like 5-hit strings. It's not really used that much in like high level play, but at the same time, it's still a cool move to have. He has like this, it's like him and Jin, his son. Like they have like this fucking like string where it's kinda like they just fuck you up with each and every limb. Like pop pop. Like left, right, kick. And it's just it's good. It's really good. I'm loving all of this shit. I'm sorry. I know I'm making 1 minute like 5 fucking minutes, but this shit is really good. Like it's cuz it's faithful to the fucking character. That's the word I was looking for. It's faithful to the fucking character to a T. That's the shit. Like let's go. Dang. Okay. Oh, yes, they got the dead hit! They got the fucking dead hit! Come on! Yes! I was joking when I said this shit! I didn't know he was gonna do it! Oh my goodness. Okay. For those of you wondering why I'm going so ballistic, one staple... Or one thing that's unique to fucking Tekken is that each and every character has a 10-hit combo string. Some of them may have one. Some of them may have up to 6. But the point is, I didn't expect Kazuya to actually have a 10-hit combo. And if you're probably wondering, why the fuck does he have so many moves? Well, the thing about Tekken is that each and every character has a plethora of moves. Let's say around 100 moves. It's because there's so many moves, everybody doesn't know every single move. Which means that people play the same character differently. They can. Some people can play it really cheesy, some people can play it really honest. And honestly, I'm loving the fact that they actually got the 10-hit combo. I'm fucking perplexed at the fact they actually have the full 10-hit combo. Look at this shit. Bro! And that's the actual 10-hit combo! He didn't change shit! He got that shit original! Original! No recipe! No KFC in this bitch! Anyway, what I'm saying here is... And shouts out to original recipe! Anyway, what I'm saying here is that this shit is going fucking ballistic, and we just started this shit. What else do you got? Oh yeah, I haven't even got to the demon form yet, bet. Speaking of fucking devil. Pun unintended.
これは鉄拳ですね。
Yes, it does.
最初にその鉄拳を紹介しなければなりませんね。改めて、鉄拳とは1994年12月にリリースされたアーケードゲームが第一。ポリゴンを使った 3D 格闘ゲームで 両手両足を表す4つのボタンにより多彩な攻撃を繰り出します。
Yeah, and also that is also a distinction when it comes to Tekken is that each button is for each limb, which is actually really cool. Like let's say you're playing with a Xbox remote, right? Let's say that X is left punch, Y is right punch, A is left kick, B is right kick, and if you're playing the PlayStation.Square is left punch, triangle is right punch, X is left kick, circle is right kick. Or in the community, the left punch would be 1, right punch is 2, left kick is 3, and right kick is 4. So if you hear anybody go say like maybe like a 2-3-4 combo or some shit like that, in other words, they mean triangle, X, circle. That's if you want to get into like how like people...talk like in the Tekken community and whatnot, but like especially when they talk about combos and whatnot, but that's another topic for another day. That's doing a deep dive right now. Let's get back to him, you know, talking about Tekken and the history of
最新作は鉄拳7、ナンバリングは7ですが、タッグトーナメントなどの種類もあり、実際のタイトルはもっと多いです。 ある日天の声が聞こえました。
Oh, really?
いや天の字が入ってる会社からかもしれません。これ海外でどう訳すんだって思いますけど。その声によると、
That was a nice joke.
マサヒロ、鉄拳をスマブラに参戦させなさい。いやー、そう簡単に言いますけどね。鉄拳やバーチャファイターなどの 3D 格闘とスマブラでは全く異なると認識しています。パンチやキックで相手を倒すということは共通していますが、ゲームデザイン的にはジャンルごと別物です。単にスマブラは格闘ゲームなのかといったよくある議論や区分の問題ではなく、ゲームの本質的にゲームデザイン論のようになりますが、
Also, I'm sorry to interrupt the man Mr. Sakurai, but at the same time, does that mean he's starting to acknowledge thatSmash Brothers is possibly a contender to be in the FGC? I'm sorry. I pulled my hamstring for that reach. Anyway, let's get back to the video. And yes, I know my hamstring is actually on my leg. I know. It's the joke.
鉄拳にはデビルインシという設定があります。デビルインシはカズヤの母カズミが持っていました。文字通り悪魔の力を引き出せるもので、カズヤもデビルインシを引き継いでいます。デビルインシはカズミ、カズヤ、息子の風間陣にあり、平八にはない。三世ファイターを平八にしなかった最大の理由がここです。また鉄拳7を見る限り、瞬時にあるいは部分的にもデビルの力を出し入れできるようです。通常技はなるべく鉄拳に寄せつつ、空中ジャンプ、スマッシュ攻撃、必殺技などをデビルの力に置き換えればスマブラでもうまくまとまるのではないかと考えた次第です。では早速デビル化を使った必殺技の説明から参りましょう。通常技はデビルブラスター。
OK、
デビルカズヤを代表する高速で飛ぶビーム。原作ではいくつかの名前に分別されていましたが、本作では通常必殺技をデビルブラスターという呼び名で統一しています。射程が長く、飛び出したら一瞬で飛び複数人を貫くことができます。貫通するとその分威力が下がります。3人を貫くとこの通り。
Good, because otherwise that should be fucking broken. Somebody would be like in aI'm so glad that is the case. Otherwise, like, motherfuckers just be spamming that shit each time and trying to get like three people out at the same fucking time.
それと打点が高いです。背の低い相手や姿勢には当たらないこともしばしば。
Yes.
そこで下入力で打ってみましょう。
Oh shit, never mind.
下方に打つことで低い相手にも当たります。同じく上方にも打てます。これは不規則などにどうぞ。
Whoa!
空中で打つと少し斜め下、位置の制御として割と使えます。空中でも少し上、少し下と打ち分けられます。
I like that. You know why? Because that means you have to know where your opponent is and try to be able to pressure them and or keep them in place. At the same time, you can't just go randomly just fucking shooting forward, and it's gonna automatically fucking adjust. No, you have to know this bitch about to go up even more. If so, I can fucking trap him, get him right there, fuck him up. Is this bitch about to just fucking fast drop or some shit? Oh no, fuck him up down there. It's good. You have to know where the character is. Again, I don't know if I'm making good game analysis, but at the same time, this makes sense to me. This is my rationale. So.
地平に打ちたければ上に。出たら強い技なので、相手の反撃が通らないとみなしたら、どんどん打って良いです。特に相手に接近したいカズヤとしては、相手から近づかざるを得ない状況を作るのは大事。
And that's such an interesting contrast to have that as like one of his special moves be such a range attack, but at the same time, every other move he has is such a close range fucking move, you know? Every other move we've seen so far, I mean, like his regular attacks.
ただ、打っていいタイミングの見極めが特徴的だと言えるんですけどね。自分で使うにも相手にするにもよく考えましょう。もちろん反射できます。
Ooh, bet! Yes! Yes!Yes. Yes. Personally, when it comes to Smash, I main Link. I know you probably want to like, what the fuck? Why the fuck would you? Shut the fuck up, okay? Don't judge me. Bitch. No. No, but honestly, I'm glad that it can be reflected. So it's not like something that can just like constantly like.Fucking beam at you, and like the person that's trying to spam the shit can be punished for doing so. And again, the point of me bringing up Link is that it sucks that my fucking boomerang gets reflected and my arrow gets reflected, but at the same time, it makes sense that way I can't just. No? Anyway.
吸収もできます。
Absorb it.
Oh. しまうことだってできます。何やってんの。横必殺技はデビルフィスト、高速で殴り抜けるパンチです。遠くで当てても相手を弱く弾くだけですが、近くで当てると相手を殴り抜けるとともに
Yes! Yeah! Okay! For those who don't know, this is a part like I look, Mr. Sakura, thank you for all the little details and nods and shit that you addBecause in the game, there's a move where you do a punch like that and you're able to go through the person. You're like, and then they fall down like that, right? It's fucking dope you added that in there. And if I'm wrong, then fuck my bad. Because I personally remember that shit where you do that fucking punch. Where you, like, you do a hit like that and they fucking go through them, then they fucking fall. I played Tekken 7 story mode. We're not going to get into that right now.But still, if you play Tekken 7 story mode, you know what fight I'm talking about, like towards the end. Anyway.
ダウンさせます。そこからの反撃をどうするのかが、上必殺技はデビルウィング。比較的シンプルな上昇技ですが、上昇高度が高いです。通常ジャンプは低いカズヤだけど、同じくデビル化する空中ジャンプの高さ、さらにデビルウィングの高さによって到達できる高度。上方向への復帰力はかなり高めです。上昇、そして割と撃墜にも使えます。出だし際強し。ところで横必殺技と上必殺技は空中での技終了後に攻撃や行動ができます。必殺技後落下にならない。ただし改めて横必殺技や上必殺技を使うことはできません。下必殺技はヘブンズドア。目の前の相手を掴んで地面に叩きつけます。
Yes! 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 Again, you play Tekken, you know exactly what the fuck is that. Oh my goodness! That is good. Okay, so Kazuya also has a move in Tekken where he fucking grabs you, turns into devil form, flies up in the air while he's grabbing your fucking face, and then flies down to the ground and slams your fucking shit. in the goddamn ground. This is good. People are gonna use this shit like the fucking Ganondorf grab. Anyway.
Super armor がついているので、無理やり掴みやすいです。クッパの横必殺技と同じく相手を道連れにできますが、相手より先にカズヤがやられることになっています。
Oh, really? What? What? That's fucking wild. That is a.
そして復帰力が高いファイター。相手より先にカズヤがやられることになっています。そして復帰力が高いファイターの場合、カズヤがやられた後に戻れます。また投げられ側の操作によって押し戻すこともできます。これ何もしてないです、
okay.
これリドリーが押し返した、
really?
どれだけ押すかは互いの蓄積ダメージ次第。ちゃんと押し戻していれば蓄積ダメージが低い時に自滅を狙われることはないでしょう。
wow.Okay, so there's a pushback too.
なお、空中の相手をつかむこともできるし、空中で相手をつかむこともできます。浮いた相手にコンボでつなげたりもします。念のためコンボというのはコンビネーション、連続技のこと。多人数戦では巻き込みによる撃墜を狙いやすいことも覚えておきましょう。そしてヘブンズドアは次に紹介するレイジシステムとも関係があります。
Wait, it's also related to the raid? Yes, okay, so also...Yeah, the Heaven's Door, in, was titled Heaven Door in this game, is also the Rage Drive for Kazuya in Tekken. At least, yeah, Devil Form just fucking comes up, go down, as I explained to you previously.
蓄積ダメージが 100% を超えると、あるいは体力性の体力が4分の1を切ると、
yes!
1回だけ、
Oh shit! Bet! Gets a fucking Rage Mode! He gets a fucking Rage! Bet! I love it! I fucking...Oh shit! I love it!
という状態になります。文字通り怒った状態。ゲージの名前表示も変わります。この状態では攻撃力は 1.1 倍になります。それだけでも単純に有利。そしてこの際、特定の条件でレイジドライブという強力な投げを1回だけ繰り出します。動作はヘブンズドアに似ていますが、威力が段違い。方法は3つあります。方法1、掴む。比較的簡単ですね。方法2、下必殺技、ヘブンズドアを使う。普通のヘブンズドアより踏み込み距離が増しています。方法3、昇竜拳コマンドプラス攻撃ボタン長押し。これは後で説明する雷神拳。
Yes! Okay! Yes! That's cool! That's cool! Cause that's low-key how it is in the fucking, in fucking Tekken!
と同じです。コマンド版のものだけは威力がさらに高くなっています。ボタンは攻撃ボタンでも必殺技ボタンでも良いけど、長押しすること。レイジ状態はレイジドライブを使ったら解除されます。時間などによって解除されることはありませんが、一定以上ダメージを受けると解除されます。またレイジドライブを狙って外すとより早くなくなります。つまり掴みを使ってるとレイジがすぐになくなるということです。狙うならちゃんと当てましょう。ファイターカズヤの全体的な特徴について解説しておきます。総合的には逆転性が高いファイターです。攻撃力は全体的にだいぶ高いです。
Yes.
手数で負けている場合もいきなり逆転したり、最終的に
The fact that he's great at making comebacks makes so much... Bro, in the game of Tekken, right? You could be at a pixel of fucking health. You play the fucking game right, you can come back and win. Okay?So the fact that he's great at comebacks in this game makes all the more fucking sense. I love it. Even if that wasn't intentional, which I'm sure it was, that's a very nice meta to the character in reference to the game. That's cool. I like that. I like that.
は逆転性が高いファイターです。攻撃力は全体的にだいぶ高いです。手数で負けている場合もいきなり逆転したり、最終的に勝ったりする場合があります。 ただリーチや攻撃範囲などでは劣勢です。攻撃が出る速さも原作ほどではないけれどだいぶ遅いです。総合的には、手数の多さやリーチの長さ、空中戦で攻めてくる相手には手を焼くかも。体重は重ため、これは吹っ飛ばされにくくて有利です。ジャンプ力は低いです。これも原作風に、ただ高さは他のものでも賄えます。リュウやテリーと同様、ワンオンワンで相手に対して向き直るようになります。これは後ろ入力の技を入れるときに便利、格闘ゲーム的です。
Yes, it is.
クッパほどではないけれど常時スーパーアーマーがついています。
Okay.
さほどの効果はありませんが、ダメージが少ない頃なら百裂攻撃などを食い止めることはできます
。 I like that.
それより攻撃の一部に強いスーパーアーマーが発動する方が大きいです。ダメージは受けますが相手の攻撃に割り込めることがあります。
I like that.Bro, you brought in the normal moves and I lost my shit because I'm like, how the fuck?
原作である鉄拳のモーションを大船そのまま実装し、必要なところを後で直すつもりで制作を進めました。操作系統を他のファイターと変えています。まず、Lスティックの入力方向は8方向で考えてください。一部、コマンド入力のようなものもあります。
Yo, what?
全ファイターの中でも飛び抜けて多い通常技の持ち主。ただ、最初に言っておきます。原作もそうですが、全部の技を使い。
Bro, I love this. Yo, Sakurai, Sakurai, yes, I love you. Thank you, thank you. That right there is already exemplifying what I was saying before by the fact that there's so many moves that each character has that people are able to play the same character differently. The same thing with Kazuya. People are able to play.Kazuya in different ways because of how many normal fucking attacks that he actually has. That he has, I mean, my bad. Still.
ただ、最初に言っておきます。原作もそうですが、全部の技を使いこなす必要はありません。得意な技を見つけ、そこから広げていけば良いと思います。なお、攻撃ボタンはいつも通り一つだけです。指示に対応した
You can do the 10 combo just by tapping A. Oh, you know how many people are going to be spending that fucking 10 hit combo, goddammit.
Oh, man. 2のボタンを仕分ける必要はありません。まずは弱攻撃。ボタンを連続で押すか、名護押ししていると技がどんどん変わります。これがいわゆる10連コンボ。相手の操作などにより全て当たるとは限りませんが、連続攻撃をボタン一つで手軽に繰り出せます。
Wait. Please tell me you can hold the last one and it makes it like a little bit more powerful. Please tell me you can do that.
なお、最後の一撃はシールド無効です。弱コンボ2発目から少し間を置いて攻撃することで、
I like this.
先行列拳。相手を吹き飛ばしたいときに使います。パパンパーンというタイミングを覚えてください。パパンパーン。
Yes.
ダッシュ攻撃は空残脚。
I like that.
遠い相手に詰め寄って打撃するのに不可欠です。下方の攻撃をかわせるし飛ばし力も高く頼りになります。前に2回素早く倒して攻撃すると左かかと落としが出ます。これにはちょっとした特徴がありまして、相手の飛び道具を跳ね返すことができます。ここから時計回りに8方向です。スマッシュ攻撃に化けないよう優しめに倒すと良いと思います。上に入れながら2回攻撃でダブルアッパー。対空や接近した相手への攻撃に使えますが、一発で止めてコンボパーツにするのも有効です。斜め上を入れて攻撃ボタンを連打すると螺旋幻魔脚。最初の1回が当たればほぼ確実に全て当たります。出だしが遅いので浮かせてコンボの締めにすると良いです。なお連打をやめれば途中で止めることができます。横に入れながら攻撃で鬼蹴り。相手を低く吹き飛ばす喧嘩キックです。ベクトルが低いので逃げり。相手を低く吹き飛ばす喧嘩キックです。ベクトルが低いので斜め前下を入れて攻撃ボタンを2回押すことでかかと蹴り。2発当てれば相手を吹き飛ばします。
1
発で止めれば相手を浮かせるため他のコンボを狙うことができます。2発目はシールド削りが大きい特徴があります。 心臓が割れなくても小さくなれば防御し手釣りが大きい特徴があります。心臓が割れなくても小さくなれば防御しにくくなるので、シールドされたら2発目まで出すのもありです。下入れ攻撃はねじり裏剣、前進しながら攻撃するので割と射程距離が長いです。姿勢を低くしつつ攻撃寸前にわずかな無敵も発生します。浮かせた相手には追撃を、斜め後ろ下と攻撃で体育抱き、相手に尻餅をつかせることができます。単体で使うのは難しいですが、横必殺技と組み合わせるのがおすすめです。後ろと攻撃で陣旋風、この技は出が早く迎撃としても比較的強く、コンボにも使いやすいので出せればおすすめです。
Hey, what's up, y'all? Yeah, so I had to cut this video off here because this video is already long as shit. It's part one. Part two should be coming up in a few minutes. It should be literally coming out right after, like one right after the other. So hopefully you enjoyed this. Hopefully you go over and watch part two.Which should be happening, but it should be coming out like literally as we speak. Like literally, it should be out right now. Okay? But in any case, this has been Two Eyes. Please check out part two. Like, comment, subscribe. And I will see y'all later.